Hi students, today we are starting our new chapter, chapter 7, jugs and mugs. Students, where we are using this jugs and mugs to measure? To measure liquid materials like milk, water, squashes, tea. So such type of liquid materials we are taking in jugs and mugs. So this lesson is talking about the capacity. This lesson is capacity, jugs and mugs. Here we have given a story of Bunno and Bunny. Bunno and Bunny. So let's read the lesson first. What story they have given here? Do you remember the wedding in Bunny's family last year? See Math Magic, class 3, page number 153. In that lesson, they have given the story of marriage ceremony of Bunny and Bunno. Bunny and Bunno decided to have a party 1 year after their wedding. In this year, this chapter, they are giving the story of wedding anniversary, their wedding anniversary. They have invited their family and friends. They made a special sweet dish, kheer. All the animals came running, hopping and even crawling. Now, here see the picture given. First one is the elephant. He is carrying a bucket for drinking the kheer. Next one is the cow. It also carrying a bucket, little smaller than that elephant's bucket. The another one is giraffe. The next one is the snails. Then the frog, the monkeys, and Bunno and Bunny are standing at the entrance gate. They are ready to invite or receiving the guest family, friends and relatives. They are standing at the entrance and the heading is written there, happy anniversary. Now, let's move to the next page, page 70, how they are celebrating their wedding anniversary. See, here the banner written there, long live Bunny and Bunno. The elephant is drinking 50 liters of kheer. As the elephant is a huge animal, it can drink a 50 liters of kheer. Now the next line given, giraffe is drinking dash liters of kheer. See the buckets, the size of the buckets, the elephant is carrying a big bucket. The cow is carrying a little, the giraffe is carrying a bucket little smaller than the elephant's bucket. That fill up we have to complete. The giraffe is drinking a dash liters of kheer. How many liters of kheer giraffe can drink? As it is smaller than the elephant's bucket, we can write it will be 25 liters of, we can imagine or we can guess it. The giraffe can drink 25 liters of kheer. And the cow is drinking dash liters of kheer. How many liters of kheer can cow drink? So that bucket is little bit smaller than that of giraffe's bucket. So we can write there 15 liters. So cow is drinking 15 liters of kheer. Then came the squirrel. Then squirrel came there. She said, I can drink 1 liter of kheer. Please give me 500 milliliters. What is the squirrel saying? It is, he is unable to drink 1 liter of kheer. So he asked, give me only 500 milliliters of kheer. The donkey asked, 500 milliliters of kheer? Isn't that more than a liter? The donkey, in every story, the donkey is considered as a stupid animal. So the donkey is asking a stupid question that, is the 500 milliliter kheer is more than a liter. Students, here before explain about this, I would like to show some relation between the capacity, their units and everything. So just to see what are the relation between their units, what are the units of capacity before giving the answer for this question. I will show you. See, these are the some important points we have to rewind before starting or showing, knowing about this lesson. See, what first you know about, what is capacity? Capacity means the quantity of liquid that a container can hold. That is capacity. That means, suppose if a bucket contains 5 liter of milk or 5 liter of water, means in that bucket we can take, or the bucket can hold 5 liter of any liquid substance. 1 liter of bottle means the bottle can hold 1 liter of milk or water or any other liquid material. That is the capacity of that container. So this is the definition for capacity. Capacity means the quantity of liquid that a container can hold. Now you know about the basic units of capacity. Liter is the standard unit of capacity. So two units I will inform you, or I will give you information about two units. First is liter and another one is milliliter. Liter is the standard unit and milliliter is smaller than the liter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. That means 1000 milliliter together make 1 liter. So what will be the half liter? Half liter will be half of 1000 milliliter. That means half liter is equal 500 milliliter. So what will be the 1/4 liter? 1/4 liter means 1/4 of 1000. That is 250 ml is equal to 1/4 liter. To make, if there are 100 milliliter containers, we have to take it 10 times. That means 10 into 100 milliliter is 1000 milliliter or 1 liter. Suppose if you are taking 100 ml of ink or liquid, any liquid material, we have to take it 10 times. That means 100 plus 100 plus 100 plus 100 equals 1 liter. That is 10 times 100 is 1 liter or 1000 milliliter. So if you are taking 250 ml in a container, you have to take 4 times. That means 4 into 250 equals 1000 ml. Here I have showed it 250 plus 250 plus 250 plus 250 equals 1000 milliliter or 1 liter. That means if you want to take 100 ml of any liquid, the container, the measuring vessel, if it is 250 ml, you have to take 4 times. That means 4 into 25 equals 1000 ml or 1 liter. If the measuring vessel is 500 ml, you have to take 2 times. That means 2 into 500. 2 into 500 is 1000 ml. So 500 plus 500 ml equals 1000 ml. That is 1 liter. So these are the relation between the units of capacity. Now I will give the answer for that our question. So we can write the answer. No, 500 ml of ghee is not more than a liter. It is half of 1 liter. Yes, is it? We know that 500 milliliter is half of 1 liter. It is not more than 1 liter. It is smaller than 1 liter. Now see, the fox said, come on, don't behave like a donkey. 1 liter is 1000 milliliter. So 500 milliliter is half a liter. Here fox is a smart animal. It is teasing the donkey and saying that don't behave like a donkey, or don't ask stupid question. As 1 liter is 1000 milliliter, 500 milliliter is half a liter. Yes, we also know that 500 milliliter is half of 1 liter. Now we will move to the next page, page number 71. How is the story going? Who are coming there? See, the next guest are coming. The frogs are coming. The frog hopped along with 9 other friends. He said, oh, we only want 100 milliliters each. As the frog is a small animal, they can't drink even half or 1 liter of kheer. They are asking, the frog is saying, one of that main frog saying that he came with his nine friends. So he is saying, we can't drink a large quantity, we need only 100 milliliters of each. How many frogs are there? There are 10 frogs. That means he came with 9 other friends. So total there are 10 frogs. Okay, here is your kheer, said the cat. While serving the kheer, she took 10 glasses of and poured 100 milliliters kheer in each glass. So who is serving for the animals? The cat is serving for the animals, for the guest. So when the frog asked for 100 ml for each, she took 10 glasses of 100 ml and filled all the glasses with kheer. So how many kheer is required for these frogs? As there are 10 glasses, 10 into 100 equals 1000 ml. That means for all together the frogs, they required 1 liter of kheer. 100 ml of kheer. Students, we know that this relation also I showed in the basic units. When I showed it, 10 into 100. So if you want to take 100 ml of 10 glasses, we required 1000 ml of kheer. ml 1000 ml means 1 liter. So for all together, the cat deserve or given 10 glasses, 100 ml each means total 1 liter kheer she served for together all frogs. So all the frogs together taken 1000 ml of kheer. Now see who came there, the next animal. The donkey looked confused and asked, 10 glasses of 100 ml each, how much is that? Again the donkey is asking a stupid question because it doesn't know the measurements of 100 ml, 500 ml and 1000 or 1 milliliter or 1 liter. So again it is asking the question, 10 glasses of 100 ml each, how much is that? Again the fox, the smart fox is giving the answer for that. The fox got another chance to show off. He said, that is simple. 10 times 100 milliliter is 1000 milliliters. That means 1 liter. Students, we know that 1 liter means 1000 milliliter. So he is explaining to the donkey that 10 times 100 milliliter is equal to 1000 milliliter, that is equal to 1 liter. 1 liter and 1000 milliliters are equal measurements. Now you can write 10 into 100 equal 1000 ml. You have to complete there. There you have to write 10 hundreds are 1000 ml, that is 1 liter. You have to complete that blank 1000 ml. Now see, now you look at the group of ants marching here. The ants are coming the last. The last guest coming with the ants group. The grasshopper said, the ants are coming. The kheer is finished. Now what can we do? The cat said sadly, because she was serving for all the guests. She said sadly that the kheer is finished. Now what can we do? After heard this sentence, the ants are asking, are we late? The ants are asking, why are we late? Now move to the next page for listening the story, page number 72. Yes, don't worry, they won't drink much. Each of them will take only 1 milliliter, that is all. I will share my kheer with them, the elephant said and wiped the cat's tears with his ear. So all of a sudden, the elephant came with the solution for their problem. As the cat was in sad mood or she was crying, how can she serve the kheer for all these ants? Because there were thousands ants were there. So she was confused. How can she serve the kheer for this much ants? So the elephant said, don't worry, I can share my kheer with them. Because one ant can carry only 1 milliliter of kheer. How many are all together? The elephant asked. We are only 1000, said the ants. The cat said, oh no, 1000. We have to give kheer to 1000 ants. So again that cat get confused. Or we have to serve kheer for 1000 ants? After thinking, the elephant said, no problem, I can manage. Each ant drinks 1 milliliter of kheer. So as the ant is a small creature, it can drink a small quantity of kheer or small quantity of food. That means 1 milliliter. Students, we know that 1000 milliliter together form 1 liter. So one ant can drink 1 milliliter of milk kheer means all together they need only 1000 milliliter of kheer. So 1000 ants drink 1000 into 1 ml equals 1000 ml kheer. That means 1 liter. They will need the same as the 10 frogs, said the donkey. Now donkey is little bit clever. So he found that the 1000 ants needed the same quantity of kheer as the 10 frogs taken. Here we know that the last page we explained that 10 frogs together they taken 100 ml of each. That means 10 into 100 means 1000 ml. That means 1 liter kheer. Altogether 10 frogs taken 1 liter of kheer. Here 100 ants also required the same quantity of kheer. That means 1000 ml, 1 liter of kheer. As all the ants drank the kheer, because the elephant shared from his kheer, he shared his kheer to the ants. All the ants drank the kheer. Everyone was happy. They sang and danced to celebrate the wedding anniversary. Students, here see the picture, how they are celebrating. The frog is dancing. Giraffe also dancing. Snails also dancing. Ants dancing. Donkey is singing. And the monkey is sitting on the donkey's back and beating the drum and singing. In this way, all the animals are enjoying the ceremony and enjoying and celebrating their wedding anniversary. The remaining story of this lesson we will explain in the next class.